I want to show y'all a few things, a few of my favorite pens. It's been on my mind lately, and I picked up a few new ones lately, so I figured I'd go ahead and show y'all. Now, this is not going to be primarily a pen video. You know, I don't know who likes to see that kind of thing or whatever. I happen to be a pen collector, so a connoisseur, if you will. But I'm going to show y'all something with my Strider in a little bit here. But I figured I'd go ahead and talk about the pens. A buddy of mine and I were talking about, you know, kind of going back and forth, talking about a couple of specific pens. And, you know, like I said, it's just on my mind. So, first and foremost, this right here is my Parker. It's a rollerball, and it uses that fairly expensive Parker refill. I mean, you know, it's not real expensive, but considering it don't last a whole long time, it is kind of. But it writes really nice. Really nice pen. Got the, you know, metal body and everything. Kind of weighty, but it's a really nice pen. Of course, you got the P up there. Parker is second to none. They do cost a little bit more, but they are second to none as far as pens, in my opinion. I love them. One of my favorite pens that you can click is this Sanford PhD right here. It's kind of modeled after the Dr. Grip, but in my opinion, nicer. It's got the triangular barrel here, gold accents on it with the burgundy or maroon, whatever color that is, you know, the body. And of course, it uses the Uniball gel refills, so it's a gel pen. And one thing I like about this pen a lot is when you click it, see there? You don't have to click it again to close it. When you go to put it in your pocket, see the tip? Watch the tip when I pull up on this clip. See, there's a little mechanism that when you release that, the tip comes in. So it's pretty cool. Or you can just click it. It writes really good. It's a nice pen. About $7 or $8. But I think my favorite new pens I just got, as far as, you know, price performance ratio. Here I go doing a pen review. Anyway, it's these right here. These are Pilot G2 Limited Editions, the Limiteds. Now, they use the same refills as your Pilot G2s. I got me some refills here. Just your standard G2 refill, you know. You got extra fine, you got ultra fine, which is really fine, and then you got, you know, fine and bold and all that. I like extra fine and ultra fine. But either way, these pens are really nice. They got metal everywhere, metal up here, metal on the tip, got the rubber here. And I figured, you know, that was all metal, but in the package I couldn't really tell what this was. I thought it might be plastic, kind of like my PhD here. This is almost a $10 pen. These were about $10 at Walmart, so I started looking at them, and I said, I'll get them and try them anyway. But turns out, they actually got a metal body on the outside here, and, you know, they're pretty well built, and they write really good. I really do like these pens a lot, so I picked up a couple of different colors. Went ahead and took a gamble on it, and I'm glad I did because they are so good. If you like the G2, the Pilot G2, then you'll like those. Now let me grab my G2. Here's my favorite cheaper pens. They're Pilot G2s. This is the ones I was telling you about. Focus. 0.38 millimeter. Really fine, and when you write with them, they're pretty scratchy. They got a really fine tip on them. So, you know, but the cool thing about these is since you got a fine tip, you're laying down less ink. It's not as bold, so you're not using as much ink, so they conserve ink, and I like that. And plus, I like the way fine tips write. So those are like one of my all-time favorites. Everybody knows about the G2. G2 is a great pen, been around a while. Of course, you saw the refills I had. Here's another G2. That's the other one. And I don't like being without, and I hate needing something and not having it. So I just went ahead, and I was over at Walmart. I went ahead and bought every single one of the G2s. These are all ultra fine. Went ahead and just, you know, bought them all. I bought the whole fucking shelf because, you know, I'm stingy and I don't like being without. So I decided to go ahead and stock up on those. I showed y'all my batteries. Y'all know how I do. I'm a glutton. I went over there to Walmart originally to get a binder. Like this right here. These are little, you know, flexible binders. FlexiView or something. They got a little place in the front where you can put your artwork. And it's bordered. See there? And I thought it looked a lot nicer than your standard clear view binders, you know. This is nice. And, I know, man. What the fuck? A review on a binder? Yeah, y'all should be so lucky. Either way, I like these a lot. They're good for my artwork. And a buddy of mine was telling me I should draw some chunkier girls. You know, some girls with some meat on their bones. So, you know who I'm talking to. How about this, bro? How about some of that right there? Yeah, I'd hit it. Wouldn't y'all hit it? I would bang that. More cushion for the pushing, baby. That's a big mama right there. So, I finally drew a bigger one, bigger girl. She's cute too. And a few of my pencils real quick. If this is boring y'all, then, you know, turn the fucking video off. A few of my favorite pencils to draw with are this 5mm Zebra. What is it? M301. Really nice. My sister knows all about these. She does a lot of artwork with these. She lays down some lead with these suckers. And my newest favorite is this one right here. This Paper Mate. But, you know. Either way, if y'all want to see more of my pens and pencils and shit, you know, y'all can let me, you know. No, I got, let's see, where we at? There's some of my higher-end pens I already showed y'all. You know, I got some of my really nice ones here. Just kind of showing y'all again. Markers. More expensive markers. Pencils, you know, stuff like that. And then, like I said, I like to stock up on shit. So, you know, I got some more markers. And there's a whole bunch of Sharpie pens. And Sharpies. You know, all different kinds of shit. And this is crazy. Right here, I got more rollerball pens, more Sharpies. Here's some clickable gel and rollers. Plenty of refills for everything. I mean, I don't know, just, I don't know. I got refills for every damn thing. There's some Precise V5s, some badass pens right there. There's some fountain pens, some Parker fountain pens with their little fountain cartridges. I gotta clean those out though. Let's see what else we got in there. I don't know. Y'all probably don't want to see all my pens. Hey, there's that red Pilot G2 and that green one and that blue one. I was wondering where those went. Either way, I got pens everywhere. Obviously, that's another one of my things I collect. But, you know, if y'all want to know more about specific pens or whatever, I'm your guy. I've been fucking with pens since I was a little kid. I love pens. I probably got like one of every pen on a shelf, you know. Except for some of your higher end ones. But I'm going to show y'all something about the Strider right quick. Now, as usual, I did not come prepared to the fucking table. Hold on. I got to get some more shit. Hold on, y'all. Man, I don't even know where I put the damn thing. Fuck. All right. Check this out. This is my rat. This is the first thing I grabbed. I don't feel like digging. But, it's my rat. And y'all seen this before. Y'all seen the pivot pin. I got the video up where I took it apart and all that and how it's built. And I said it was, you know, built pretty damn good. And, you know, it's got a pretty good little pivot in there. Pretty good size pin, right? And look at this one. That is a mofo. And I was thinking, you know, that's cool. Maybe it's just a big fat head on a little screw, right? You know, This is a little screw with a little bit bigger head. I'm thinking, you know, maybe there's a big fat head on it. You know, kind of like mine. But either way, I'm going to show y'all how I clean and lube my big tool. Y'all want to see me clean up and lube my big tool? Of course y'all do. Okay. Slip that thing in the hole right there. Start screwing. And I pull this thing out. Okay. Look at this shit, y'all. Damn. That is a screw for your ass right there. I started looking at that and I'm like, that is a monster. Big old pivot on that thing. So, yeah. Confirmed. All right. Let me grab this right quick. Got my little grease rag. I'm going to go ahead and, you know, get my screw and start squirting some lube. Some rim oil. Reason I'm doing that is just I'm going to get some of the gunk off of it, you know. It had some, like, kind of lint looking shit on it, so I think somebody was messing with it before I had it. And they decided they was going to take the screw out, and it had some crap in it. So I'm gonna go ahead and clean that off real good. Alright, it's clean. So I cheated a little bit. Already took it apart and I kind of cleaned down in there. I got my little brush and I kind of my little brush that I use for my Glock, and I kind of cleaned it. So that part's pretty good. Now this part I just saved because I wanted to do it on camera. And I'm going to get my little Loctite right here. And I'm going to stick me a little bit of Loctite on my screw. Not much. You just want a little, ooh. All right, now. That's a little much, but that's all right. It's a big screw, so it can handle a little more. Now I'm going to drop it down in there. And I'm going to push the other fucking side out when I do that. What a dumbass. I told y'all I already had it all cleaned up and everything, so it's real slippery. Note to self, next time, push the damn side, the other side with the thumb, so it don't slide out. I'm gonna lock it down right here. Give it a little bit of torque. Check it out. Nah, a little bit more. That sounds about right. Alright, so in about 24 hours, that Loctite will take hold and, you know, cure. And it'll keep that screw from backing out on me, so my Strider will lock up nice and tight. You know what? I'm going to back that off just a tiny little bit. Not much. Yeah, right about there. I've got to make sure I can flick it the way I want with my index or my pointer, like that. That's how I do it, like that. So, pretty good. All right, play, no play, nope. All right, y'all, I just Loctited my Strider. I told y'all I Loctite all my knives when I first get them. Pretty much get it set how I want it and Loctite it. And just so y'all know, I got a video on this already, you know, but this is what you want to use right here if you want to get your screw back out easily. You know, it won't back out on its own really, but you can get it back out if you want to. This is Blue 242 thread locker by Loctite. Not cheap, but damn good stuff. This right here, this tube will last you a little bit, you know, because you don't really have to put that much at all. And it's real good on your knives. Keep you nice and locked up. And, you know, that's all you need, really. Alright, I'm going to let that do its thing. And we're going to see about how it locks up. I know it'll work. All right, y'all. Guess what? How about I do another 15 minutes on pins? Y'all want to see that? All right, y'all. Let's see some pins. No, I'm just fucking with y'all. I might do a video on pins later on, but for right now, I'm going to get out of here, so...